So you can find where a creek intersects with a road here on public property. You can see there's a big bulkhead here, the bridge that forms the bulkhead that forms the bridge. And you can hear we've got fresh water coming in right over here. That's just an ideal situation. You want fresh water, we've got fresh water on both sides coming in out of these big tile over here. So you got to kind of pick your spots. Some creeks aren't as good as others. Some call them creeks and some call them creeks. So we're going to give this a go. My shadow's probably not helping anything, but not much I can do about that. There's one. Now here's a big one. Here's one of the ones that we want to release. Got to tighten my drag for this guy. Okay, now here's one of the brood stock. This is a big Blue Creek chub. That's some pretty fine bait right there. It's a little too big for the purposes that I want. So I'm gonna let this one go. I'm about ready to go get my pliers and pinch down that barb. It makes it a lot easier. Now I'm going to give this guy a pitch. I'm going to toss him up about 20 feet because otherwise they scare off all of the little fish. On your little jig, you want to pinch down the barb with a plier and it'll make it a lot easier to release them. I'll show you the difference between that last one and pinching down the barb with a needle nose. And it just seems like when I use a bobber today, they're not wanting to take a bobber. I'm just throwing it upstream, letting it drift down on the bottom slowly until it's actually vertical below me, right in the shade, right below the bridge here. It's actually a culvert bridge. And with something like this, there's probably hundreds of shiners and chubs underneath here in the shade. A few work out, and as they work out, then that's the one you'll catch. If it's more overcast, they're apt to be roaming. Now even just a little piece of weed like this on your hook, they're going to reject that bait. They can see that just plain as day. And there's one. And there's one last perfect one, about a four and a half incher. And with the barbless hook, it just pops right out, where otherwise you're really gonna work at getting them off. So, and that's one thing about barbless hook, you're gonna lose your bait a lot more often. Fishing with a bare hook never works. Rarely, anyway. Easiest way to do this is just run your hook right into the worm like that. Just take your thumbnail and just cut off. So good luck fishing.